Hey, YouTubers, welcome back to Galactic Gaming. This is Hatfield 15 reporting for duty, and today we are back with what will sadly but triumphantly be the very final episode of Metroid Samus Returns. Last time we played this game, we ventured around Area 6 and 7, collected a whole bunch of items. I think this Super Missile expansion should be the very last item. And then if I take a look at the map here and to check out Area 8, yeah, we've got a big majority of the items here, but I'll just run through because I think that because there's an item there and an item there. I was playing on my own spare file and I was able to get that item right there. Thus, I know how to get to it quickly and efficiently, so hopefully we can end off the series today. So just before we begin, you guys, can this video please hit 15 likes? And if you're watching this and you're not subscribed, please be sure to smash that subscribe button if you want a shout-out. Be sure to show your subscription to me publicly if you want to make sure you get a shout-out. Speaking of which, I want to give a shout-out to a new subscriber of mine. This shout-out goes out to your average Joe. So if you're watching this, thank you for subscribing and stay tuned for more. So without further said, we are all systems go for what will be the final episode of Metroid Samus Returns, a truly wonderful game by Nintendo. In 3, 2, 1, it's time to end this, ladies and gentlemen. Again, like I said, I've had a dazzling experience playing this game from the absolute beginning. But like I said, I'll be doing that little segment like I always do at the end of these series that I do. I'll be doing that little segment I typically do while the credits are rolling and I just do my final thoughts on the game. But first and foremost, we need to get to that Super Missile expansion. I was close to getting it by the end of the previous video, but I had screwed up horribly. Oh yeah, that's pretty much one reason I screwed up is because I had ran out of Aeon. But anyways, we're gonna go ahead and get all that Aeon, which will fill up our Aeon reserve tank. And now, since we have, or at least we should have everything, we can now actually go along. Okay, crap, lightning armor. Okay, I'm gonna have to stop into a bit of my Aeon already just to get rid of that freaking thing. All right, let's actually just try and go as far as we can without using Aeon. I'm gonna try and blast those Aeon sappers from up there. Okay, I got one of them, and there's a turret, right? Yep, there's a Chozo gun right up there, but we'll just dodge out of the way. I don't know what you're still aiming at. I'm all the way over here. Now, we've got to try and get back up to that little place. Okay, no way. I think we can. Oh, yeah, we can. I'm pretty sure, yeah, there is a way to that obstacle from there. Okay, I'm not sure. Like, can we? I'm not sure. I'll have to do it with Morph Ball Bombs. Okay, good. We can do it with Morph Ball Bombs. So, that was an easy way to get up here. Now, let's see. Is there blocks here? Okay, good. There are blocks here. Oh, okay. So, here is a power bomb boost station, or at least a power bomb boost spot, I should say. It's not exactly a station, but we're over here nonetheless. Alright, I think I may have gone... Yeah, I've gone a little bit too far now, so... Crap. Okay, this is gonna take a little bit of trial and error to get this, what I hope to be the last item for Area 7, but you know what? I guess we'll just go ahead and find out. Okay, you know what? I'm good with taking a little bit of health. I have all this energy at my disposal. Again, it's mainly just, Aeon that's an issue, so we'll just... Okay, we're gonna tap into lightning armor just so it'll protect us. I didn't want to have to do this, but again, there's an Aeon orb just right over there. Okay, no, I should just wait. All right, let's go ahead and get that lightning, get that parry in there, because you know I'm all about the parry. Okay, crap, that happened, so power bombs away. I hoped I wouldn't have to use my power bombs since they're so powerful and in short quantity, but you know what, it's fine. Plus that Aeon blackout didn't really last that long. So, let's just continue along our day, just hopping up. Oh, okay, did I just seriously blow up just all of those blocks right over there? Oh, right, that's where we were supposed to go. We were supposed to bomb that block. What the hell is a blom? All right, here we go. Phase drifting time. Now, we're going to be careful here. Okay, good. We got past that. Like I said, it's mainly conserving Aeon that's the big issue here. All right, there were some breakable blocks or instant crumble blocks right over there, but I still have plenty of Aeon, but I now know, or at least I now remember the surprises that are right over here. Okay, I could go ahead and beam blast that stuff, but that probably wouldn't be too effective now, would it? Alright, you know what, let's just power bomb the place, see which blocks are breakable, or at least the ones that crumble. Alright, I see it. I've got a lightning armor and phase drift. Okay, I can get rid of phase drift. Now, we're gonna do this again. Okay, cool, that should be it. And whoop-de-doop-de-shmoodly-doo, that is our Super Missile expansion. Let's see. Perfect. That's 100% of the items for Area 7, you guys, otherwise known as the Chozo Laboratory. Well, again, I've heard a whole bunch of stuff about this place. Yeah, well, when I look at the music for it on the internet or whatever, it says Chozo Laboratory, and that's the exact music for Area 7. So yeah, this place is pretty much Area 7. There are only, like, generally, like, literally two items we have to collect in Area 8. One we couldn't access earlier because of the baby Metroid crystals, and then, of course, one that I was just too lazy to go ahead and get. Alright, that should be... Oh, okay, that's just occurred to me that we have two expansions left, so one of our next expansions should be a missile tank, and then the last one should be a power bomb expansion. Yeah, telling from the looks of it and telling from the stuff I've heard about the game in which you need just a specific amount to actually have it as the 100%. But then again, it does say, like, it does give you, like, specific counters for, like, areas, for all the items in a specific area, so I guess that's something that's already, like, a start of it. Alright, so again, this is pretty much it, guys. This is the last time we're going to Area 7, so I may as well enjoy it. Okay, again, I'm not going to tap into my... Well, actually, I could tap into my Aeon if I wanted to. I mean, I've got everything done. Like, I've got all the items from here, and I have gotten past that phase obstacle, finally. All right, I'm going to take some damage. Okay, no, I'm not going to take some damage. I thought I wouldn't be able to kill that guy fast enough. All right. Okay, nope, those are some screw blocks. We could just screw our way down here. All right. So long, Chozo Laboratory. Oh, wait, you know what I just realized? We can easily use the teleporter station to get to Area 8 much faster. Jeez, I completely forgot about there being a teleporter station right over here. So, okay, nope, we took some damage there, but I'm not too worried about it, seeing it's a small amount of damage. Okay, nope, let's just see. Alright, lightning armor, let's just see. Is it? Okay, yeah, it is through this little patch of weeds. Alright, this is it. Goodbye, Area 7. It's been a good one. And overall, goodbye to Metroid Samus Returns, because again, I've had a lovely experience playing this game. Alright, let's see. Which teleporter station is closer? Okay, nope. This teleporter station is closer to the one particular item we're going to first. Again, there are two of them, but I'm mainly wanting to get the last missile expansion that is behind those energy those baby crystals. Like, again, seriously, this teleporter sequence, like, this teleporter cutscene is very, very satisfying. It looks a lot like Northern Lights. See, we're just missing the green and the Northern Lights. Okay, here we are, guys. Area 8, the final area. Okay, that's right. There was an item right down there, but I was able to get that without even having to destroy any of the baby crystals. Like, seriously, Area 8 is just so much different, and going to this place is a lot different after we defeated the Metroid Queen back in what I believe was February. Yeah, I'm pretty sure it was February that we fought the Metroid Queen. Alright, yeah, that guy's just gonna go nuts, in which I need health, so I'm not exactly Aeon. I'm all topped up with Aeon, but, yeah, I suppose anything of the ordinary would be good. Oh, okay, crap, that's right, there's those things right over here. Okay, I should just activate lightning armor just because, yep, obviously that did quite a bit of damage. I mean, with these snail thingies, like, whatever these, like, these speedy snails that explode, like, they take up, like, a full tank of health, like, literally a full tank of health, and yet they only do, but they only take up a very tiny fraction of your Aeon reserves. Okay, yep, there was that one item. Okay, I don't know, like, normally you can parry those guys, but I guess not because of the whole them being electrified thing. And you can only parry an enemy attack when there's that little click beforehand, like the white flash and then the little clicking noise that occurs right before the enemy charges at you, in which you can parry the attack. Oh, okay, yep, that's right, lightning armor. Well, I suppose we're okay with health. Yeah, and this should be the last time we had to beam burst. It was a good one. Alright, baby, eat up your dang crystals. They're healthy for you. I'm not sure what health effects they have on you, but they're healthy nonetheless. Alright, guys, now we're all topped up on energy, what I believe to be Aeon, super missiles, and, yep, this should be it, guys. This next item, which I assume will be a power bomb expansion, should definitely, in all certainty, be the last item. And thankfully, I'm smart enough to remember how I got it in my other save file, the one I just do my own separate time. I try not to make more progress in what I do in this save file, just because I'm trying to do it, like, spoiler-free. Okay, throughout the whole series, I've been trying to keep this camera angle. I've been trying to position the 3DS so that it shows the top and bottom screen, so that's just been kind of an issue for me throughout the whole series. But again, this is the last episode, so that shouldn't be much of a series. But then again, like I keep saying, I will likely be doing a bonus episode after all this is over. Okay, I don't know why. Okay, sorry, the thing was just, yeah, the right bumper was just acting up on me. It hasn't been acting up much recently, so that's a good thing. Alright, yeah, like I said, this is the power bomb expansion that I got on my own save file. The one, I definitely know how to get this one. Okay, if I can just get past these freaking, okay, if I can just get up here, that would be good. Woo! Oh, boy, that was good. Okay, one more beam bursting. Again, all the Aeon abilities are handy in their own ways, and I'll be talking talking a bit more about the Aeon abilities and what they were to me in my little game review once we got to the credits, in which that shouldn't be too much longer now, because that's it, everybody. That is 100% of all the items in the game. Wow. Like, again, simply wow. That's really, it's really impressive to see how far we've come throughout the course of this series. I mean, it all started with landing on SR3DA, learning the controls because I am not really familiar with the 3DS setup, and then, yeah, we just eventually went further and further and getting more Aeon abilities, fighting more Metroids, and just doing all the wonderful stuff. Okay, it's only, like, one power bomb I'm missing and just a little bit of Aeon I'm missing, but I may as well, since this is the end of the series, I may as well just go ahead and top up on it, and I'll get rid of you. Nope, we're gonna get rid of you, or we're just gonna dodge you, and then get rid of you. Okay, good, that's that. And now here is the last time we'll be using an ammo refill station, even though we only have to refuel, like, what, one power bomb? Alright, let's see, which teleporter station would be closer? Okay, the one closer to us is all the way up there, so of course we gotta go through this annoying arse puzzle all over again. Okay, oh yeah, that's right, that led us to that missile expansion, so I don't have to do all that stuff. Okay, it's a little daunting there, because I'm trying not to use my power bombs, like, I'm trying to keep power bomb usage at a minimum, just because they're so powerful, and they're very handy for getting to other places in the game, but, yeah, again, it could be, it's a little daunting, because I'm trying to not waste my power bombs, but, yeah, of course, I end up doing so in the end. Alright, let's see, where is the freaking, okay, there's the exit for this little area right over here. Now, if we could just go along here. Okay, yeah. Oh, yeah, that's right. I remember this is kind of the way out. Again, it feels so different coming back to all these areas without having to hunt Metroids, because, again, we've exterminated all the Metroids. Like, they're all dead thanks to our brilliant efforts. So, yeah, I mean, again, Metroid Samus Returns is all about hunting and exterminating the Metroids. When you're actually going back after eliminating all the Metroids, like, after you've killed all the Metroids and you're going back to all the areas to try and get 100% of the items, it just feels different. Like, you know, it just feels so different because you're not having to fight Metroids. Well, in the original Metroid 2, you could easily go back and collect all the items before you fought the Metroid Queen, which was the final boss of the game. I mean, the Metroid Queen was the final boss for this game, so of course this isn't going to exactly to be a climactic ending. But again, it's more climactic to me when there is actually a final boss right before the end of the game. That seems a bit more climactic to me, but hey, like I said, I'm not really one to complain. Well, I am kind of one to complain, because I have had such a fun time playing this game ever since I got it in September 15th. But hey, look at that. Like I said, we've got 100% of the items. Again, it's a little more helpful because we had all these item kill. There's an item percentage for each particular area. Oh yeah, that's right. When we go back up to this part of the surface, there's that very unsettling music for whatever reason that may be. Alright, I may as well just go ahead and try and complete the map. So, Scampulse for that. Oh, okay, nope. Okay, oh, I thought I could. And that last, ladies and gentlemen, that was one last good melee counter. So, let's head on back here and end off this series. That was Metroid Samus Returns. Well, I guess this is it. After a long journey, it's finally time to go home. Oh, you like my ship, little squishy? It's a combination of my ship from Super Metroid and a flying saucer from... What the hell is Ridley doing here? Wait, squishy baby! Squishy baby, come back! Ridley, you better let go of my squishy baby right now, otherwise I'm gonna hurt you. Well, I'm pretty much gonna hurt you in any case, so taste the plasma, boy! Okay, wait, I'm actually looking at Ridley right over now. It looks like I'm looking at some early body features. It looks like this must be some kind of, like, meta Ridley. Okay, my right bumper is acting up, so you know what? I may as well just go ahead and beam burst the crap out of this boy right over here. Taste the power of me, Aeon Ridley. Of course, this probably isn't a good idea, because again, the right bumper is acting up in probably the worst time right now. Okay, I should use the remaining Aeon for a lightning armor, but then again, I was just complaining about this not being a very climactic ending, because there was no final boss, but holy crap, if I got the final boss I'm looking for now, because, yeah, whenever Nintendo doesn't have any new ideas for a sudden final boss of the game, you just gotta slap a Ridley fight in there. Take that, Ridley. Wait, where are you? Hey, get the hell back here, Ridley. Sure, the baby's gonna end up on Zebes anyways, but I'm not gonna let you take it this early, even though Super Metroid happens, like, not even a couple hours out the end of this game here. Bring it on, Ridley. Yeah. You like that, Ridley? Remember that feeling of good old plasma beam? Alright, come to mama, squishy baby, or come to papa in this case. Yet another fine ass kick moment by Samus Aran, ladies and gentlemen. Okay, there has to be more to that boss fight, because that was, like, way too easy. Of course he's not dead. So, Squishy Baby, how about you wait with the ship? Papa's gonna be an extra few minutes. All right, Ridley, round two. Let's do this. Boy, I'm ready for you, as always. Ooh, wow, I like this music. Oh my god, look at Squishy Baby. Look at Squishy Baby on the ship right over there. He's just using his little body as a pom-pom. He's the perfect little cheerleader. So forget all those hot girls you would find in your average high school or the typical, like, stereotypes for a cheerleader. So whatever you... Because who needs those hot chicks in your average high school when you have a good old Squishy Baby using his own body as a little pom-pom? That's pure cheerleading skills right over there. Okay, of course the Aeon Field didn't refill my reserve tank. Okay, I'm gonna have to hit you in specific spots here. Okay, I'm just gonna have to be a little bit dodgy here because Ridley is coming out fast and furious, as always. Well, again, this could be, again, like I said, this could be like a form of, like, meta Ridley. Oh, okay, that's a new move right over there. Definitely unprecedented. Okay, I've lost the last of my Aeon, so I gotta be careful here. Okay, wait, I'm looking at some more body features of Ridley, so I wonder, like, there's some yellow to him, so I wonder if it's, like, some kind of, I wonder if he has some kind of Aeon powers, but that wouldn't make any sense because, again, he just arrived here on SR388 out of nowhere. Okay, crap. Okay, all right, there we go. That got him. Okay, now, of course, that's probably not it. So, round three? Probably round... Since when can Samus use a jetpack? Okay, I'm sorry, that could be like a jetpack used for like a speed booster and space jump, but seriously, since when can Samus use a jetpack like that? That's a very nice Ridley theme we got going on there. Okay, I seem to be a bit of in a tight situation. Wait, what are you doing, Squishy Baby? Now, where have I seen that before? Oh, I don't know. Squishy Baby saves you from the big bad final boss at the last minute. Oh, yeah, that's right. We last saw that back in good old Super Metroid. And, of course, it looks like Squishy Baby completely refilled my health. So, looks like we're doing round three with Squishy Baby, boys. Woo! Taste it, Ridley. Yeah, you like that good old feeling of plasma beam? Really doesn't feel good anyways. Well, even though Other M happens quite some time after this. Okay, that's our missile reserve tank. Okay, it only refuels 10 super missiles. But, hey, like I said, I'm not exactly one to complain about it. Okay, I wonder, well, maybe this is like the Arachnus boss fight, in which there isn't really an opportunity for you to parry it. Okay, that's how that works. Okay, I've got some Aeon, so I should just lightning armor myself. Okay, wait, whoa! Okay, I think I actually dodged that at the last moment. Okay, we're kind of running low on super missiles, so I may have to resort to charge attacks right over there. Woo! Alright, taste it, really? Okay, I'm just gonna use... Oh, okay, so that's... I forgot that was how that attack worked. Alright, taste it, really? Okay, this is a really interesting boss fight. I mean, the different phases are good and all. Like, Squishy Baby, can you actually absorb all of his energy so we don't have this problem? Okay, alright, that melee counter kind of caught me off guard. So, alright, let's pump a full of Aeon. Taste the power of Aeon, Ridley! Man, that actually felt very satisfying right over there. But, okay, cool, looks like, that's what we gotta watch out for. Whenever Squishy Baby sucks the life force out of Ridley, that's when he's gonna do that melee counter. Because that melee counter nearly caught me off guard, but it didn't catch me off guard because I'm too boss to have been caught off guard by that. Sorry if I was messing up my language right over there. Okay, yeah, I should be a little more cautious here. Again, Squishy Baby, you could be actually a little more useful. I mean, I see you're just gonna be giving me a little bit of help with each time I have the opportunity to parry one of Ridley's attacks, but could you be a little more useful and actually, like, absorb the last of, like, full-on, like, suck Ridley's life force out? I mean, I didn't think Squishy Baby would be able to handle the amount of life force Ridley has, seeing how big of a creature Ridley is compared to Squishy Baby, but, hey, I guess I stand corrected, because once again, I have underestimated the Metroids. Alright, here we go. I'm ready for that melee counter this time. Woo! Alright, I'm ready for it. Alright, I'm ready. Okay, it doesn't look like I'm getting an Aeon from it, but I may as well just go ahead and pump this guy full of Aeon. Okay, no, I mean missiles. Okay, that didn't give me any Aeon. That's strange. I don't think I've ever encountered a melee counter in the game that doesn't actually give you any Aeon, so that was rather strange there. It doesn't look like regular missiles will affect Ridley, so it looks like we're taking it the long way this go-round. Alright. Oh! Holy crap! We beat him! How's that feel, Ridley? Let's see, that's Samus, I don't know, 10 billion? Ridley, zero. Okay, now he's dead. Man, that was a pretty good fight, but then again, now we finally got that climactic ending I was kind of chatting about there. Squishy Baby, you actually did a pretty good job fighting off Ridley. I didn't think you'd be able to handle his life force, but once again, I've underestimated the Metroids. Too bad you'll actually be doing that sort of thing again in, like, not even a day after the events of this game. Oh, wait, I wasn't supposed to tell you that. Well, in this case, shh. Alright, off we go, ladies and gentlemen. That's it. Wait, that can't be it. Okay, yeah, that's not it. Well, mission accomplished, guys. All Metroids have been exterminated. Except for this cute little squishy baby. Alright, I suppose the right thing to do is deliver it to the Ceres space station, like in the beginning of Super Metroid. So with that being said, guys, it's time to fly off to the Ceres asteroid belt, which will kind of double as our space sunset for the ending of this game. And that's it, everybody. That's the end of Metroid Samus Returns. Wow. That's simply all I can say about this game in short. Just wow. But in long, as I've explained before, I've had an exhilarating experience playing this game. I mean, there's so many, like, a lot of good things to like about this game. I mean, the graphics are actually pretty damn good. I mean, this is a 3DS, so they could be a little bit better. But again, the graphics are actually pretty good for a 3DS game. Before I forget about this, the artwork in the opening cutscene of the game, where it shows the Federation being attacked by space pirates and just telling the story about how the Metroids came to be a threat in the galaxy in the beginning. That artwork was really good. I'm really impressed about how well Nintendo did with that artwork right over there. That is some pretty good ending music right over there. But then again, that's probably one of the other major things I liked about this game, is how brilliantly remade the music is from the original game. I mean, a few good examples are the baby theme, definitely the service of SR3D8, as I've explained multiple times. And just, of course, we got that good old Magmore Caverns or Lower Norfair remix for the Heated Caverns, whatever you guys prefer to call it. But anyways, again, one major thing I want to talk about in terms of Samus's ability is not like the game itself. In terms of Samus's abilities, the melee counter is a really big step for Samus, and that's because in most other games you'd have to have lightning fast reflexes to try and dodge an enemy attack, otherwise you get damaged. Well, in Metroid Other M, that was a little bit of a step further because of the whole sense move ability, where it actually lets you rocket out of the way of an incoming attack, whether it be melee or ranged, which, might I add, not only looks cool as hell, but it instantly charges up your beam so that you can immediately strike back with an even more powerful attack and likely kill that enemy. But the melee counter was an even bigger step further for Samus in this game, because as opposed to actually dodging out of the way of an enemy, you can just straight up parry an enemy attack right there on the spot, leave them stunned, and then strike right back with a melee or beamer missile attack is what I meant. Ah, the good old Diggernaut. I remember how this guy was a pain in the booty, but we only died 3 times in this game. Meanwhile, you look at my attempts in Metroid Other M, where I died like 20 times or whatever. But yeah, speaking of which, the Aeon abilities, as I said earlier in this video, the Aeon abilities were another really big thing about this game. They're each and every Aeon ability is handy in their own way. I mean, the scan pulse, for the fact that instantly reveals a big part of the map and temporarily the location of breakable blocks. I mean, normally you'd have to go to a map station and for each area to reveal the entire map, which doesn't really reveal the location of items, but that's what the scan pulse does. Even though it reveals a shorter area of the map, it reveals the location of breakable blocks and the location of missiles. And then, of course, we got my absolute favorite of the four, lightning armor. Lightning armor, not only does it make Samus look cool as all hell, but it uses up Aeon only to block enemy attacks and to use the melee counter, like, make it actually bigger. And then, of course, beam burst and phase drift. Even though they went through Aeon the absolute fastest of any of the other Aeon abilities, they both came in really handy, whether it be absolutely annihilating absolutely anything in the path or just slowing down time long enough to actually get across some crumble blocks. Well, the phase drift could work in a couple of ways. It could work by literally slowing down time, or maybe it speeds up Samus to the point where everything's just moving so slow around her. Overall, again, I'm just really impressed about how well Nintendo did for this game. So that being said, guys, I'm gonna have to give this game a rating of 9.3 out of 10. Well done, Nintendo. Well done. Okay, I would clap, so I just thought I'd clap the desk right over there. But like I said, guys, I will be making a bonus episode of this series later tonight where I'm checking out all the concept art, the concept art and all the sound tests and all that stuff. So make sure you guys tune in for the bonus episode of this series, which I'll be putting out maybe when this video is uploaded, I'll start making the bonus episode for this series. That was truly a triumphant ending for such a triumphantly and well-done made game. But we still need to see our mission final, which is always a good thing for Metroid games. I'm not really concerned about endings, but I just want to see how I did. Alright, hey Samus. Of course you need a remix of the mission final theme from the Metroid Prime games. Of freaking course you do, Nintendo. Clear time, 10 hours, 25 minutes, and 13 seconds. You know, that's actually not that bad of a timing. I could have done a little better, but like I said, I actually took my time with the game and actually enjoyed it as I went through. See you next mission. Aw yeah, it's been a while since you've seen those fateful little words on the ending screen of a Metroid game. See you next mission. Okay, we got Samus with her helmet on, but like I said, I'm not concerned about endings. I'm just more so concerned about taking my time and actually enjoying this game as I go along. Alright guys, that's pretty much it. That's gonna go ahead and end off the series. You know, I'm actually, like, starting to get legitimately a little sad now that the game is over because I've had that good of a time. But, like I said, there's a bonus episode coming out maybe a few hours after I've posted this video. So make sure you guys leave a like and a comment on that. Make sure you guys leave likes and comments on all my other videos for the series. Seeing how well they did with this game, I'm obviously excited to see what they do with Metroid Prime 4. So I guess we'll just see what Metroid Prime 4 looks like when they hopefully unveil a trailer at the upcoming E3 in June. Once more, 9.3 out of 10 for this game. And to quote US Gamer from the Accolades trailer for this game, in short, they nailed it. So with that being said, that concludes Metroid Samus Returns. That's about all the time we've got today, so thank you all for joining me today. Be sure to subscribe, leave comments down below because I like them, and crank that like button to the max like Soulja Boy. Till then, I'm Hatfield15, and as it says up on the screen, I will see you guys in the next mission. Space out, bros and brositas. Thank you for watching.